Hello all. In this video, we are going to discuss about syntax directed translation. So a syntax directed translation means it is productions plus semantic rules. So a grammar productions is associated with the semantic action is called as SDT. So for example, A tends to BC followed by the semantic action. So it may be any function, a function of b1.val, c.val, etc. So grammar production plus semantic rule is called as SDT. So each grammar production is associated with the semantic rule. Then the grammar symbols are normally consist of some attributes. The attributes may be type, value, any integer number, anything. And these attributes can be evaluated with the help of the semantic actions associated with the grammar productions. And the attributes may be synthesized attribute or inherited attribute. Synthesized attributes means it can be evaluated from the children. And inherited attributes means the values can be evaluated from the parent or siblings. That is, in synthesized attribute, for example, if A tends to BC is a production, then the semantic rule is assume that V is a attribute associated with the non-terminal, all the non-terminal symbols. So A dot V, the attribute for A can be evaluated from B and C also. So it may be a function of B dot V comma C dot V. So synthesized attribute means the value can be evaluated from the children. And in inherited attribute, if you consider A tends to B, C, D, then the semantic actions may be this B. The children, B dot V, the value of B can be evaluated from the parent or from the siblings. So B can be evaluated from A or B can be evaluated from its siblings C and D. Similarly, C can be evaluated from D. C dot V is equal to D dot V, and D dot V can be A dot V or B dot V or C dot V, anything. So if the values of the grammar symbols, the inherited attribute means it can be evaluated from the parent or from the siblings. So B's value can be evaluated from either A or from the siblings. But in synthesized attribute, A, the value of A can be evaluated from only its children B and C. And there are two types of SDTs, S-attributed SDT and L-attributed syntax directed translation. So these are the differences. First one is, S-attributed SDT uses only synthesized attribute. That is, if A tends to BC means the value of the synthesized attribute can be calculated from the children. And in L-attributed SDT, it uses both synthesized and inherited attribute. So we can say, the difference like this: all the synthesis, all S attributed SDT are also L attributed SDT, but the reverse case is not possible. S attributed SDT means it's it has only synthesized attribute, therefore it is called as S attributed SDT. In L attributed uses both synthesized and inherited, but here the one restriction is in inherited attribute can be evaluated from the parent or from the left siblings alone, not from the right siblings. Therefore, it is called as L attributed because it is evaluated only from the left. So for example, A tends to B, C, D means the B's value can be evaluated from A. Similarly, C can be evaluated from B, B's value or A's value, and D's value can be B's value. But if you write D dot C dot V is equal to D dot V, then it is wrong. This is wrong, okay? Because it uses both synthesized and inherited attribute, but in inherited attribute it can be evaluated from its parent or from the left sibling alone. In this case, c dot value can be taken from d dot value, so this is wrong. So therefore it is called as L attributed SDT. And the second difference is semantic actions are always placed at the right end of the production. So for example, A tends to BC means the semantic actions can be written at the end of the production, but in the L attributed SDT it can be placed anywhere on right hand side. So for example, S tends to semantic actions followed by B and C, B semantic action C, then BC followed by D. So the semantic actions can be written anywhere in the right hand side of the production. The third, the final difference is here the attributes are evaluated during bottom up parsing. So for example, if you have a parse tree like this, the A's value can be evaluated from B, C and D only, because it uses only synthesized attribute. So after finding the values of B, C and D only, we can find the value for A. So it can be evaluated from bottom to top. And here attributes are evaluated by traversing the parse tree depth first and left to right. So for example, if you have the parse tree like this, then from A we can find the value for B, then from B only we can find for C, or from A we can find C. So that is depth first and left to right traversing. So these are all the differences among S attributed and L attributed SDT. Then we will see one example for S attributed SDT and L attributed SDT. This is an example for S attributed syntax directed translation. That is a simple disk calculator. These are the set of productions and semantic rules. The first production is L tends to EN. So here the semantic action associated with this production is print E dot val. And here for each non-terminal symbol, the synthesized attribute val is associated, because S attributed SDT means it has only synthesized attribute. So each non-terminal symbol is having a synthesized attribute val, and the digit is having the synthesized attribute lex val. Lex val will take get the value from the symbol table. So L tends to EN means here the semantic action is print of E dot L, and here the N represents a new line. So after printing the value of E, it will go to the next line. Then E tends to E1 plus T. So value of E is evaluated from its children. So E1 dot val plus T dot val. So we have to add value of E1 and T. Actually, E tends to E plus T is a production. To differentiate E on the left hand side and right hand side, we have used 1. But the actual production is E tends to E plus T only. So E dot val is equal to E1 dot val plus T dot val. So a parent is calculated from the children. Value of parent is calculated from the value of its children. Then the semantic action associated with this production is E dot val is equal to T dot val. Similarly for other rules, T dot val is T1 dot val into F dot val, T dot val is F dot val, F dot val is equal to E dot val. Here the parenthesis is used for grouping only. Then F tends to digit means F dot val is equal to digit dot lex val. Now we can construct the annotated parse tree for the example 2 plus 4 star 5 n. An expression, this n represents a new line. So annotated parse tree means parse tree with the associated parse tree with attributes is called as annotated parse tree. So we have to construct a parse tree for this example. So L, the start symbol of the grammar is L. L tends to EN. So first E and N, then this E can be replaced by then we need addition expression. So E can be replaced by E plus T. E plus T. Then this E before plus we need 2, so E tends to T. We can use this production. Then T can be replaced by F. Then F can be replaced by digit. Then E plus, after expanding digit and plus, we need to expand this T. So T can be replaced by, after plus we need the multiplication by expression. So T can be replaced by T star F. Then this T can be replaced by F. Then F can be replaced by digit. Here, this F can be replaced by digit. So here, we can get digit plus digit star digit n. So now, we need to use the semantic rules for evaluating this expression. So F tends to digit. So first, we need to find this. So digit dot lexval is equal to 2. Actually, here digit dot lexval means it can take the value from this symbol table. So here the first value is 2. So digit dot lexval is equal to 2. Then F. Now we need to find the rule for F tends to digit. F tends to digit. What is the semantic action for F tends to digit? F dot val equal to digit dot lexval. So digit dot lexval is 2. That is assigned to value of F. F dot val is 2. Then T tends to F. What is the semantic action associated with T tends to F? T dot val equal to F dot val. That is, this F dot val is assigned to T dot val. So 2. Then E tends to T. The semantic rule is T dot val should be assigned to E dot val. Then we need to evaluate this E. So before evaluating this, we need to find the value of T. Then only we can calculate this. So here digit dot lex val is equal to second value is 4. Then F tends to digit. So F dot val is digit dot lex val. So F dot value is equal to this 4. Then T tends to F. T dot val is F dot val. So 4. Then here digit dot lex val is 5. Then F dot val is equal to digit dot lex val. That is equal to 5. Then we need to find T. So what is the semantic action for T tends to T star F? T tends to T star F. The semantic action is T1 dot val into F dot val. This should be multiplied and that value is assigned to T dot val. So the right hand side T. So 4 into 5 is calculated. 4 into 5 is 20 is assigned to T. Similarly, E tends to E plus T. Here the semantic action is E dot val plus T dot val. So 2 plus 20 is evaluated and that is assigned to E dot val. So 22. Now semantic action associated with L tends to EN. So here E dot val is printed. So this 22 is printed and it goes to the new line. So the this is the annotated parse tree for this example. Next, an example for L-attributed SDT. It can have both the synthesis attribute and inherited attribute. Here, the non-terminal symbol L is having inherited attribute and T is having the type, synthesis attribute type. And this is the production for declaration statements. So, a declaration statement may look like this. A type followed by comma-separated identifiers. So, a declaration statement tends to TL. T means T tends to integer, real, so any type, T tends to character, anything can be, any type can be included here. Then this L, this is for getting the list of identifiers. So this L tends to L, ID. Then this L is a recursive procedure. It can be again replaced by L, ID like that. Finally, it should be replaced by ID. So by using these two rules, we can get the list of identifiers. So this is a set of production for declaration statement and these are the semantic actions associated with it. Here L is a inherited attribute. So its value can be taken from the parent or sibling. So L dot in means the type information for L. L dot in is taken from T. T dot type is assigned to L dot in. Then T means T dot type is integer. T dot type is real. Here L dot in is equal to L1 dot in is equal to L dot in. It's taken from the parent. And also whenever ID is there, its type should be entered into the symbol table. For that, add type procedure is used. So add type of ID dot entry comma L dot in means then the type for the particular identifier will be entered into the symbol table. So here L tends to ID means ID dot entry and L dot in. So this will add the type to the symbol table. Now we need to find the annotated parse tree for this example. So first draw the annotated parse tree for this. So the start symbol of the grammar is D. D can be expanded by using this production TL. Then we need int. So out of these two productions we can use T tends to int. So T can be replaced by int. Then L can be here we need three productions. So L tends to L comma ID must be used first. L comma ID. Then again this L can be replaced by L comma ID. Again this now L should be replaced by ID because we need three identifiers. So now we have to this is passed from depth first left to right. So first we need to find the value for T. So T tends to int. What is the semantic action associated with the T tends to int? T dot type is equal to integer. So T dot type is equal to integer. Then L. So this L can be here we need to find L tends to L comma ID. Sorry, D tends to TL. Here D tends to TL. So the semantic action for D tends to TL is L dot N is T dot type. So this L dot in is equal to T dot type. So its value is taken from its sibling. So int. T dot type is int. Now L tends to L comma ID. So the semantic action is these two. So this right hand side L dot in is equal to L dot in. That is a child value is evaluated from its parent. So this child L dot in is taken from int, parent int. Then add type of ID comma entry and L dot in means this information will be entered into the symbol table. Then again L tends to L comma ID. So L dot N is in is equal to int, its parent. Then again this information is entered into the symbol table. Then this will also be entered into the here the information will be entered into the symbol table. So here how this information is entered into the symbol table, ID ID dot entry comma L dot in. L dot in means its parent. So ID and its parent value will be entered into the symbol table. So ID and integer, here ID and this integer, and here ID and this integer will be entered into the symbol table. Thank you.